Welcome back to Elden Ring. Let's explore the city of Noxtella. Starting with the Night Maiden riding the ant. Oh, can I use Torrent here? Oh, I'm at a disadvantage. Why can they ride, but I can't? Okay, so what happens to the mount? Oh, the eyes aren't colored anymore. I guess that's the control that indicates that the Night Maidens have control over them. Oh, no FP. So cool. Nox Swordstress armor. Ooh. Is that the same as the Night Maiden? It looks very similar. Very, very similar. Yeah, mostly the difference is in the back. The Swordstress is a bit longer. And has like a single cape in the back instead of like individual ones. Yeah. Oh, damn, that does a lot of damage. Lots of those silver tier husks, but I haven't seen them with electricity around them before. Only the ones down there have that, the ones up there don't. Oh, there's the snails! Wait, where exactly did I come from? I know it came from just right next to the side of Grace, but did I come from up these stairs? I kind of don't remember how I got here. No, I definitely was here. Oh, there's an item over there. Need to remember to get it. Did I come from in here? Nope. Ah, dodging's too good. Tell which of these are a chest and which are just, well, something like a chest, but not a chest. Ant's skull plate. Oh, it's a shield. Like, okay, no, it's not a chest. That one's already broken. I'm just gonna roll into every chest-like thing. Oh, causes poison buildup. Takes 28 strength, though. Huge head of one of the giant ants which inhabit the two underground rivers, used without modification as a shield. Excels at repelling enemy attacks. Giant ants are venomous creatures, granting a boost to immunity when wielding this shield. The antenna move. Oh, these ones are electric. They explode when they die. Oh, they have little goo shields. Ah. Oh, you know what? I'd be good against them, actually. Well, I don't want to get too close. That actually works really well. F-
fake?
Not fake. Ghost Glovewort Picker's Bell Bearing. Oh, that reminds me, I have another bell bearing I need to use. Archer ashes. Spirits of archers who belong to the Fallen Hawks, a band of soldiers that once explored the Eternal City. Their arrows are imbued with cold ghost flame. Though their methods are somewhat crude, they work well as a squadron, firing a hail of arrows in unison at the sound of a war cry. Window. This just keeps going up and up and up. Is there a boss in there? Is that one of those sentient balls that you can target? Yep. Ooh, hi. How much that would have hurt me if it hit me. Oh, we need keys to get inside. Okay, Night Comet. This is the real one. Night Maiden and Swordstress Puppets. Ooh! An old puppet crafted in the Eternal City. These sisters, members of a cold-blooded race who wield flowing weapons, became puppets of their own volition. Hmm. I see you. Get down here. Great Ghost Glowfort. No item ahead. Still gonna take a peek though. Yeah, there's nothing. Legs? Legs. They're tired of walking. There's a pathway over there. Be wary of up. Oh, it's a ball behind the chandelier? Or whatever that thing is. It can't fit through the door. I think this might set off a chain reaction, because I think they blow up each other. Yeah. Okay, this is going up and up to something very important. I see a bunch of bloodstains up there. I was expecting to find a site of grace. Maybe there's one just up here. Weak foe ahead. Might actually be weak, or that could just be code for very, very strong foe ahead. I'm really surprised how far we've gone without a sight of grace or even a shortcut. That is so good. Noxtella. It's a talisman, I think? Yes. Increases memory slots. I certainly don't need that right now. Maybe this is a shortcut? Or just return to where you were before? Not much need of a shortcut since it doesn't continue over there. Oh, no, we have not been here. If only I had a grace, exactly. Please? Go back and finish exploring the area around the original site of grace, but I would lose so much progress if I went back right now. Nope, still can't use torrent. Really sure the best way to fight these things. I don't want to go up and use the ancestral infant's head on every single one. I guess I can just do this. Ah, that didn't even do that much. That works. Oh, let's blow one up. That should blow them all up. You have like a second to hit them before they turn around with their shields. So if you hit them really fast, that can also work. Ahead. Oh.
Yay, centipede.
Ambush, but no item ahead. Oh, but just nails. Oh. Okay, I think we're... never mind. I was gonna say we're back where we started, but... where the hell did we even... I don't know. Dear God, I have no idea where I am. Wait. I already got the... Have we completely looped around? Are we right next to the bonfire? We did completely loop around. Okay. Well, actually, I don't want to rest at the bonfire, really. I don't want to respawn all the enemies. Let's grab this item that I missed next to the bonfire, magic grease. Back up here, I did forget to go to the right here. Ah, that was it, just a smithing stone. Let's keep exploring over here where you come down the elevator from. Oh, shit. Ooh, we got the crown. Pretty, but not for me. I love watching it swish back and forth, though. Where does this go? Oh no, it's getting away. Nope. Yep. Wait, what did I get? Huh? Okay. This place feels so big, it feels like I really should be able to use Torrent. Okay, these are going to be a little bit tough. See where this goes. Still a waterfall basin. No item ahead. Okay. All right. Yeah, the Dragonkin soldier. We fought it right here. I remember looking down from this waterfall and actually seeing this exact site of Grace and thinking, I want to get to it and I don't know how to get to it. So it looks like this mainly gives us access to this little waterway, which looks like it might lead to an entirely new chunk of map. Let's go back here. Respawn everything by teleporting back here, so let's spend our souls. Oh, we're just short of two levels up. Let's get one int and one vigor. Yeah, so I wanted to explore over this way. Yeah, we checked the waterfall, we killed that. Actually, yeah, no, we already were over there. Still feel like I'm missing something, though. I don't think I went up here. Ow. Okay, I think that was the only thing I was missing. Back to down here. Worry of something. Okay. Undead ahead. Ah, the basilisks. Try ranged battle. This place looks nasty. Why is it so red? Years ahead. Lake ahead, but scarlet rot. Lake of rot. Oh, yay. Time for incantation. Time for coffin. So can I just walk on that stuff? Or... please tell me I can use torrent. I can't use torrent? Oh no. What is all that? My God. There's a couple like little tiny structures in here. Like in the lake, kind of around the sides of it mostly. But it looks like the main thing continues here. Yeah, I'm gonna get Scarlet Rot in like 2 seconds. There's no point in using like Scarlet Rot resistance. It's not gonna increase it enough for me to be able to survive for more than a couple extra seconds. And Scarlet Rot hurts you so fast too. I can partially counteract it with the Flask of Wondrous Physic, but I'll still take more damage than I'm gaining. Let's go for it. Oh, whoa, why, actually, am I taking extra damage because I'm, like, standing in it? Because I didn't think Scarlet Rot did that much damage, but maybe it always did. Jesus Christ. I'm gonna have to teleport back to the site of grace in just, like, a minute. Yeah, it really does just hurt you that fast, even when you're not standing in it. They could just swim in it? Little bastards. Well, I think that's about as far as I'm getting there for now. Should I just switch my potions over to healing, I guess. Oh yeah, that reminds me. I might be able to increase the amount replenished. Do I have a sacred tier? I don't. Do I have 4 golden seeds? I did, apparently. I'll still leave a couple FP potions, but yeah, most of them. Let's see if I have anything that I can do for my wondrous physic that would do anything for this. I'm gonna keep the heal. Explode. That only protects me against one hit. Lightning attack, holy attack. Boost stamina. Dex int fate. Nah, that's not really gonna help me. Oh, whoa, what's that do? Ooh, we're building a little bridge. I love how this Lake of Scarlet Rot looks. It's just really cool looking. I think this is another part of the bridge that we can build here. Oh. Huh. Not quite what I was expecting. I want to go home. What is that? They're just chilling out there. Ah! I think I'll just ignore him. That looks like an Erdtree avatar or something over there, I'm not sure. Okay, build more, build more. I'm almost out of FP, or not FP, healing. Crimson. Dragon? Well, I guess I gotta teleport back. I wanna go say hi to that person just chilling in the Scarlet Rot, walking around. That's it? Immunizing Horn Charm, plus one. Oh, that's probably very relevant for this, I would think. That's all around that thing in the center, like we're supposed to fight it. So I'm guessing we do. No precious item ahead, really? Yeah, I don't see an item in there. Oh wait, there's one above though. See if we can get it just before we run out. Actually, our Crimson Rot's gonna run out, so we'll be fine. Use this vantage point first, though. I think there's another pillar over there that we can probably build more with. I don't think I used that one. Mushroom crown. Not really my thing. It's very heavy. Mushrooms found growing all over the body. These overgrown mushrooms form a towering headpiece. Raises attack power when something nearby suffers from poison or rot. Long ago, great lords served the scarlet rot. Perhaps such fungal bodies served as their crowns. Let's check the talisman. Oh, we already had the base form of it, but greatly raises immunity, which governs resistance to poison and rot. I should probably also have some preserving boluses. The scarlet rod gauge goes down so slowly. Ah. No, no, no. Oh, when did I actually get poisoned? Didn't even realize I was dying. Okay, we got that button over there. Let's go for the dragon, or whatever that thing is. I'm gonna get Scarlet Rot, but that's fine. Let's use a bolus. Okay, yeah, are you gonna come to life? Because you really look like you're going to. Yep. Oh. Jesus. Well, I'm dead. Ugh. Oh, come on. One more hit. Yes! Dragonscale Blade. The hardest part is always finding it. There it is. It's a katana. Dex weapon, takes 20 dex, 12 strength. Has a special that is, well, rather special, ice lightning sword. A weapon made by sharpening a gravelstone scale, thought to be the source of ancient dragon immortality, into an unclouded blade. Alas, the dragonkin soldiers never attained immortality and perished as decrepit pale imitations of their skyborn kin. Ice lightning sword, call down a bolt of ice lightning into the blade and bring it down upon a foe. The ice lightning effect will persist for a while. I think that's something I should try out. I mean, it's a dex weapon. It has a cool sounding special. It's a katana. I already use a katana. Let's see what the special looks like. This is a persists for a while. I assume that gives me bonus damage. Oh, look at that. Oh, that is so cool. The streaks it makes when you move it around. Yeah, that is really cool. How much FP does that use? Fair amount. But yeah, it does persist for a while. How much bonus damage it gives you. I don't know, but I think I should teleport back and spend my souls. Let's get a point of dex. So this one we already got, yes, but I don't think I got that one. Whoa. Okay, we go up on this one. Ah. So that's how you get up there. What's down there then? I don't know, but let's explore up here. Hmm? One of you. You want to use that sort of magic? There, taste of your own medicine. Alabaster Lord's sword. greatsword. Doesn't require much strength, though. Only 16. I'm only 2 away from being able to use that one-handed. Yeah, strength, dex, and int. Alabaster Lord's pole is the special. Greatsword forged from a blue-white meteoric ore. The blade conceals gravity-manipulating magic. A weapon unique to the Alabaster Lords, a race of ancients with skin of stone, who are said to have risen to life when a meteor struck long ago. The special, it says it has a greater area of effect than Gravitas. So I guess it's like a better version of it. Pulls the enemy in, just like they did to me. Gotta two-hand it. There we go. Looks like it has a pretty wide area of effect. Try ranged battle. What, killing the dragon from here? Good luck with that. Can't even target it from there, surely. Either that's it, or I think more likely we're missing a piece. Is there another button down there? It's an entrance to something over that way, as well as that way. Wait, there's a ladder here? I think I hear a beetle, too. Oh, there's the beetle. I think this is just how we have to get up now. Because that thing's not going to come back down for us to step on. The bloodstains would suggest... Actually, what do they suggest? Because it looks totally safe to just walk down there. What's the problem? Did you just fall off? Oh, they're probably all dying from Scarlet Rot. Yeah, I think they're just all dying of Scarlet Rot. Grand Cloister. So yeah, nothing seems to be stopping us from just continuing on down, but I don't think we're done with up there. I want to go this way and see if we can maybe finish constructing that thing, that like risen platform. But I think I'm going to save that for the next episode. So I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.